won't be long. Better back them up, boys.
Thank you, Father. How many can say, thank you, Father? Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. For believing in us. Amen. Praise the Lord. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Hallelujah. I want to start out tonight in Matthew chapter 10 and verse 7. It says, and as you go, preach, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out devils. Freely you have received, freely give. Hallelujah. What have you received freely? In that I was seeing, you have received the power to heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out devils. Freely you have received, freely give. Amen? Hallelujah. I was, I read this, on Facebook, and it really touched me. I'm trying to think who placed it on there. I believe it was one of my friends that used to work in the ministry. Anyway, she was talking about, and what I'm leading into, was talking about the Galilee, the Sea of Galilee, and the Dead Sea, and how they're both fed by the same source, the Jordan. The sea, and you may all know this. This is just a little teaching, I guess, or reteaching. Anyway, it talked about how the Sea of Galilee has a way. It gets fed from the Jordan, and then it has a way of releasing what comes in from the Jordan. So it's got an entrance in, and it's got an entrance out. And so, therefore, the Sea of Galilee is full of life. You know, so I'm thinking, you know, we're all seas of Galilee. Amen. We all have rivers of living water. We sang that in our song tonight. Rivers of living water flowing through us. You know, and as the Word of God and as the Holy Spirit pours into us, what are we supposed to do with what He pours into us? We're supposed to release out of us the very thing that God is pouring into us. We do that through prayer. We do that coming together by faith, the coming in agreement. And then in the same sense, you give life, because you're a life giver, amen? Whereas the Dead Sea, same source, it's coming from the same source, the Jordan's feeding it, but it has no outlets. So therefore, it's not giving out what it's receiving, therefore it's dead. Interesting, huh? So are you alive tonight? Or are you dead, so to speak? Hallelujah. There's a lot of people out there that need the river of life coming into them and going out of them. There's a lot of us as believers have a river of life running in us, but are we letting it flow out of us? You know, and that's where I believe praying in the Holy Ghost, coming together in corporate prayer, what we're doing is releasing that river. Amen. We're giving life as we declare it out of our bellies. Amen. I mean, that was a real revelation to me. Same source. God is our source. Amen. There's believers out there, same source. And there are those that are walking in victory, same source. And there are those that aren't. But it's the same. God is still their source. What's the difference? They're receiving and releasing what God's given to them. You know, you think about, I'm receiving healing. I know we've said those sort of things, but I'm thinking, no, we have received healing. We're not receiving healing. We have received healing. Now it's up to us to release the power of that healing that's within us. Not only will it affect us, but it'll affect those around about us, even to the point where if they touch you, the healing virtue that's in you will go out of you into them. Amen? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Father, that we just walk in that true revelation, Father, of the Word of God that is dwelling on the inside of us, that life-giving power that dwells on the inside of us. Father, that we are your vessels, we are your temples of the Holy Ghost, the power of God residing in us to quicken our bodies and to quicken those that come into our presence. For the power of God is in us, amen? Hallelujah! Thank you, Father, that we walk in victory. Father, that we walk in the victory, because the Word of God is the victory, and the Word of God dwells on the inside of us. Hallelujah. Ever releasing power, ever ongoing, never stopping power, God's power on the inside of us. Hallelujah. Ola brande leste. Stir yourselves up. Gola brande leste la rabba. Sile osto. You guys on the internet, stir yourselves up in the Holy Ghost. Release the power of God that's within you by way of the Holy Ghost. Sura bande leste. Ile osto ra la brasita. Charge de le brosondale brese. Ile stora ba ki sota rabba. Stir it up within you. Ile osta la rabrasi. That life-giving power, that resurrection power, that estela brondolo stele rabrasiasto, ila mandele este, ila broso, where sickness and disease cannot be, in Jesus' name. Ila broshondrabande, from the top of your head to the very tips of your toes, that healing virtue running through you continuously. In Jesus' name. Ile ostalabrana. Not something that we're gonna get, something that we have already received. Hallelujah. You know that you're saved. Amen. Know that you're healed. Know that you've been delivered from lack, brokenness, despair, depression. In Jesus' name, that you have the mind of Christ. Hallelujah. That you're being renewed in your spirit. Hallelujah. And your spirit's renewing you. Hallelujah. La brosh tele rabrandele. Don't settle for anything less than the power of God, His best in you, working mightily. Hallelujah. To affect you, to affect your family, to affect your children, to affect your parents, your teachers, your bosses, the ones you come in contact with at stores, wherever your feet take you. The power of God is in you to set the captives free, to heal the sick, to cleanse the leper, to raise the dead, whatever is needed. The Holy Spirit leading you and guiding you and showing you what you are to do at that very moment, every moment. Hallelujah. We have the mind of Christ. Hallelujah. The devil has no place. Hallelujah. In our thinking, he has no place. He has no right to take away our memories. He has no way to take our very lifestyles away from us. He has no place in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. None. Amen. Hallelujah. And to everyone, I just lift up everyone that's been affected by the rains in Jesus' name. Ones that have lost their homes. Father, they've lost everything that they have. Their clothing, their bedding, their furniture, what the place, their roof, Father, their vehicles. Lord, I ask in Jesus' name, a supernatural happening, Father God, that you're going to come in and you're going to sweep into these people's homes and you're going to restore back to them what the enemy has taken from them in Jesus' name. Father, I just pray peace for everyone that's been affected by these rains. And Father, I thank you that in spite of that, Lord, that it's a sign to us in the spirit, Father, for we know that what's taking place in the heavenlies, it's a manifestation on the physical land. Father, that the word is pouring out into the church body like a flood. The revelation of your word being poured out into the body of Christ like a flood. Moving every obstacle out of the way. You know, when those rushing waters come through, it takes everything out of the way. I don't care what it is. I mean, it can move a vehicle in a matter of 2 feet of water. Just take it. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for such an outpouring of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus, a flood coming into every nook and cranny, every byway and every highway. Father, with the water of your word. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And you know how that's all going to take place? How that's going to get in motion? How that's going to start doing? Because a fire is going to come up on you and you and you and you. A fire is just coming up out of every believer. A fire. All these little fires coming together. And one big wildfire in Jesus' name. Coming across this nation. In Jesus' name. Woohoo, babies. The church is growing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We own this nation. This nation belongs to the believer. Hallelujah. God bless America. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. For the church that lives in America, I thank you for the body of Christ in America, and I thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus, that we're taking our rightful place in Jesus' name. We're getting in the right position in Jesus' name, and we're taking our country back in the name of Jesus. Righteousness will prevail and is prevailing in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, that you're putting in position, you're placing the right people in the right place. You're doing it. Calling those things that be not as though they are. I believe the church is praying. I believe the believers are praying. And I believe that the manifestation of God's presence in this nation, you shall see. Hallelujah. Do you believe it? Yeah. We're still here. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Ila sora bandele stele rebilio sandale caso toraba. Indolo bush nere asia sora bacase. Idele ondolo broshoto. Ila sete. Lift up your nation. Ele ustala rabrande. Kile ustala rabrasia stele onda. Ila brande from the top. Ile brosondale estelaso. Indalo kushnere ehe. Ila brandele osto. Hearts changing in Jesus' name. Ila shotraba. You're setting it up in the name of Jesus. You're bringing the right people into the right place at the right time, speaking the right word in the name of Jesus, that their ears are open to hear, receive, and do. In Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Eleosto, every name. every knee shall bow. Ele brondala shikisata, ele broshondala, ele ostorabasi kase, ele ondala rabrasi ostorabase tere brondele brasi astala broso. I don't hear you praying. Ila sorabandele stele rebre. Iko sotorabashi astalabra. Kile brondolo sotorabashi terea. Ile orama. Ile moshitileasa. Ile broso totorabasi kasa. As you receive, freely give. Ile ostalabrandi stalabrondo. Out of your bellies, durabile ostalaramande. He knows. He knows. He knows. Ile broso tarabrasi astande. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for mindsets being changed in Jesus' name. Wrong thinking out of the way. You get out of the way. Good is good. Evil is evil. It's been turned. No more in Jesus' name. Good is good. Evil is evil. Hallelujah. Ila sorabashe kese. Ora bandele oshasa. Set the pattern. Ile oshtal rabrase. Kile oshton rabasiasto. Ile ondala rabrase te. Ole shtala rabri. It starts at the top. Ida bandilishto rabba. Kile oshtala brasi istenda. Ine mondo rabrasi astora. Ile oshtala rabri este. Ina mandolo ston rabasitile from the ida sora. To the brose, idam brose, from the dostala to the brose, ile brestili andala, ile broso, and everything in between. Ina masho kosetele, you astora bashne, you de stora basotora, ibilese, bilese te ostaha, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. The intensity of your desire. Hallelujah. How much do you want it? Hallelujah. Ola sam saha sahale te broka sandala si sta ile storabashne ina mandala brondele. We take it back, Lord. We take back our schools. We take it back in Jesus' name. Ila brondele shiti. Even to the point, Lord, we take back our bathrooms. Devil's a liar. Istora. In Jesus' name. God is good. Evil is evil. Hallelujah. One voice. In Jesus' name. One voice. Many voices. One voice. We become one voice. Hallelujah. The word of God out of your mouth. Hallelujah. Declare, let the redeemed say so. Hallelujah. Amen. It's not the complaining, it's not the harping, it's not any of that that changes anything. It's the word of God coming out of your mouth that changes it. In Jesus' name. It's the Holy Ghost coming up out of you that changes it. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. The kingdom of God is at hand. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Hallelujah. Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, bring them to Jesus. Hallelujah. For those watching on the internet, if you're not plugged into a church, get plugged into a church that declares the word of God. That there's no compromise. There's no walk in the fence. There's no in between. It's the uncompromised word of God. That you see the Holy Ghost flowing. That you see the gifts of the Spirit flowing. That you see people getting healed. That you see people getting delivered. That you see people coming to Jesus. Get in a church that has life. Get in a church like the Sea of Galilee, where there's life coming in and there's life going out. In Jesus' name. Get plugged in. Forsake not the assembling of yourselves together. Hallelujah. I'm talking to those that just don't get plugged into anything. You know, I understand that you don't always have the opportunity to get to church. But don't let the internet be your church, if it's at all possible. Get plugged into a body of believers. We need one another. We need family. And what's so great here is that this is family. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, I know people that are believers that aren't plugged into church. They have no family. Some of the elderly, they have no family. You know, we reach out to our, I don't want to say the word elderly, I guess, but there's a lot of people that are alone that are older, you know, and sometimes they just get to that place where they begin to isolate themselves. If that's you, get out of that thinking in Jesus' name and get plugged in to a body of believers. Hallelujah. Father, open that door. Show them, Father, where they're to go, where they're to be in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for that divine appointment, for that little lady sitting there all alone, for that little man sitting there all alone, where hope has been lost, where they just feel so lonely. Lord, bring a knock at their door. Show them someone. Have someone reach out to them, Father, to plug them into a body of believers in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. If you've been hurt because you've been in a church and you've been hurt, God is the healer of the brokenhearted. Forgive. Just let it go. Just forgive. Just do it. Just forgive and get your life back. Don't let unforgiveness eat you up, because it will. It's a robber. And I just thank you, Father, that forgiveness just rises up in their hearts. In the name of Jesus, Father, they just let it go. It means nothing no more, Father, that you just fill them up with such a love, such a desire in Jesus' name to open that door and to take that step back out into life again in Jesus' name. Then they're not operating like a dead sea. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. You know, and that can be a young person too. That can be a teenager. You could be a teenager watching, and you feel all alone in the name of Jesus, to the point where you might even be thinking, why even live any longer? I say to you, let your life begin now. Hallelujah. Let God just fill you up, and let him show you his love. Let him show you his love, because he will. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Glory be to God. That we're sensitive, Father, to those around about us in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Lord. 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 Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. God is good. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for this little blessing. This is the first time I've seen this little guy. Aren't you sweet? Thank you, Lord, that he's blessed all the days of his life. Father, he's highly favored all the days of his life. Thank you, with long life you will satisfy him. I thank you, Lord, that his footsteps are ordered of you, Lord. I thank you, Father, that you have a mandate on him. And at a young age, Father God, you're going to show him what it is. And he's going to step out in it in an early age. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Oh, it's okay. Thank you for the babies. Out of the mouth of babes. I'm waiting for one of these little guys one of these days just to prophesy. How would we react to something like that? That all of a sudden he just started prophesying. Hallelujah. Can you believe it? Praise the Lord. Why not? Hallelujah. Make a donkey talk. Hallelujah. Have you ever seen a donkey talk? Nobody has? I have. No. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Has anyone got anything coming up in their spirits they would want to share or have us pray about? Oh, come on. I know we're in this together. That's why I like us all coming together and almost rubbing shoulders in corporate prayer. Now, the back row is almost rubbing shoulders. There, because you're close. It's like, okay, let's all get together and rub shoulders. Hallelujah. It's like, I don't know. Anyway, praise the Lord. I'm a stickler for that, I guess. To come together and to hear one another pray. It really is good to do that. That, because iron does sharpen iron. And sometimes, you know, I know growing up and being in different churches and being involved in a lot of different prayer groups and intercession, the ones that I thrived and grew the most in, there was a closeness. There was, we got together. And we heard one another. We listened to one another. And you began to get into that, because you're hearing one another, you're getting into that same vein of the Holy Ghost. And there's power in that. And I know I've spoke that before, and I will continue to speak that. Hallelujah. There's something about getting in that same vein. And you're not all off in different places. We're all in the same place. And I think a lot of that comes in the way of hearing one another. Amen? How many agree with that? Got some hands up. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Anybody? It's a free mic. Thank you, Father. By the Holy Ghost. No one? John? Oh, okay, Vonda. I mean, we got... There's a reason to speak out what's coming up on the inside of you. It's for agreement. It's just to get it out there and declare. You know, the angels go to work with it. There's so many things that we need to learn that we have to vocalize and not keep within us. And not let fear or thinking, well, what I have to say really doesn't mean nothing, because that's not true. Not in this setting.
There's a young lady out there. She's watching. And you're trying to decide if you want to keep that child. They don't tell you that when you wake up the next morning that you mourn that baby. They don't tell you that your body hurts. That baby is loved. That baby is not a mistake. So right now, I just ask that you go to your Heavenly Father. He will make a way. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Anyone else have anything that needs to be shared for someone out there that needs to hear? I think it's about somebody. I think tonight's out there. More so than in here. Amen.
I was sitting here remembering how I was searching and didn't know I was searching. Because life as I knew it was over, but I didn't know what was next. And there was a loneliness that I didn't even recognize really, because a man's a man, you know. A man don't cry, a man don't this, a man don't that. But I'll never forget, once I started searching, I'll never forget the Saturday night that I'm sitting in a chair all by myself and knew I wasn't alone. And as far as what Fonda said a minute ago about a baby, the Lord showed me a while back that there's a lot of things in the world about that we look at as being wrong or out of wedlock or out of this or out of that. But what God has made, there's no mistake. You can't look at something living and say it's not supposed to be. Don't work. Whoever you might be, God loves you and wants to come to you right now. In Jesus' name, amen.
Praise the Lord. You know, things take place in our lives because of choices that we make, paths that we take. But the one thing we all know, and everyone in here knows, and I speak to you out there, is God always makes a way. He always makes a way to clean up our messes. You know, take a mess and turn it into a message. Hallelujah. Take a test and turn it into a testimony. Hallelujah. Because God gave his only son so that you might have life. Hallelujah. So that we would have life, not only just life, but abundant life. Nothing missing, nothing lacking, nothing broken. You know? Hallelujah. That our thinker thinks right. Hallelujah. Our memories are in place, are intact. We know who we are. Amen. We know each other. Thank you, Jesus. Thank God I'm in a church of believers. Thank God I know that that you believe the way I believe, and that we know that the Word of God is the truth from the front to the back, and there's nothing left out, that He's the healer, He's the deliverer, He's the God of goodness, He's the God of greatness, He's just El Shaddai, the God of more than enough. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's like Brother Copeland always says, one word from God can change your life. Harvey?
We often quote John 3:16, for God so loved the world, He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him will not perish but have everlasting life. I believe the main thing is love. John 3:17 says, He did not send His Son to condemn me, but through Him I might be saved. That's love.
Amen. Not condemned, loved. Amen. Hallelujah.
I'm going to go back to what Gloria said when we opened up about releasing, you know, the love, you know, love that comes in. Earlier today, I was reminded of a quote, and it's Winston Churchill. I'm going to paraphrase it. All it takes for evil to thrive is for good men to remain silent. That's the church. When we remain silent, that's when evil, that's when it gets to grow. That's the reason, if there's a word here, you've got to release it. You are stopping evil in its tracks when you open your mouth and you release the word. Don't be embarrassed. Don't hide. You're good men. You're Christians. You've got power behind you. He wouldn't give you a word to say to embarrass you. You're not going to be wrong. And if there's something, you know what? We don't all get it right all the time. We are working on it, and we are getting better and better, and we are growing, and we are becoming more Christ-like every single moment of the day. But to grow, you have to open your mouth. Don't let evil win. Quit being quiet. He didn't ask for a quiet church. I haven't seen that word anywhere in the Bible. Please show me that it says, church, keep your mouth shut. I haven't seen it. Please show me if I'm wrong, because, man, it's hard to keep my mouth shut sometimes, and I'm... Nah. I know, it's a surprise. But, you know, guys, there's something. Every single person in here has got something to say to somebody. And it's not you building yourself up. It's doing what the Holy Spirit has put in you and deposited with you because the Father told Him to. And Jesus came to this earth as a man to make a way for that to happen. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Praise the Lord. God is good. All the time, God is good. We are the carriers of His power. We've received, and now we need to release. Amen. And that benefits, you know, releasing that power of God within you all the time. You know, keeping yourself stirred up. You're releasing that power of God in you all the time to keep your body working, to keep it quickened, to keep it in place, to keep it in shape, to keep your mind alert, you know, to keep you in protection. It's to keep you. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Anybody else before we close? All is well? Everybody's well. Anyone need prayer, hands laid on them? Or slapped or something? Just, I thought I'd get you laughing. It's like a good medicine. Hallelujah. Father, we just thank You for tonight. I thank You, Father, for each and every person that came here tonight. Father, for their faithfulness, for their commitment, for their love for one another. Father, I just thank You for this family. And I thank You, Lord, that You just continue to keep them, to guard them, to protect them, to strengthen them, to quicken them, to prosper them. Father, they are blessed to be a blessing. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. God bless you.
As you've watched today, you've had the opportunity to hear the word preached. And as you apply that word, you'll get victory in your life. But it has to start someplace. It has to start first with a commitment to Jesus Christ is making him your Savior and then making him the Lord of your life. Paul said this in Romans 10, 8 through 10. It says, but what does it say? The word is near you and it's in your mouth and in your heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. Well, the word of faith that Paul preached is found in the next verses. It says that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, then you'll be saved. For with the mouth confession is made unto salvation, and with the heart one believes unto righteousness. So it goes like this. All you have to do is actually say, Jesus is my Savior, and He is my Lord. So I'm going to invite you to say this with me this morning. And if you want to bow your head, you can bow your head. The Bible says that pray watching, and so it's okay to keep your eyes open and watch. But let's say this together. Say, Father, I know that you sent Jesus to die for my sins. I confess those sins today. I ask you, Jesus, to forgive me of those sins and to come into my heart and be my Savior. And I commit today that I will make you the Lord of my life. Thank you for salvation today. In the name of Jesus, amen. If you said that today for the first time, no matter what time of the day or night it is, welcome to the family. Welcome to knowing Jesus Christ as your Savior. Now from this day on, make Him the Lord of your life. And as you make Him the Lord of your life, you will find out what God can do in you and through you. Also, if you've watched this broadcast, we want you to know that you can become a partner with this ministry. As you become a partner with this ministry, some of the things that you've seen throughout this presentation, the buckouts and things like that, then you become a part of that kind of ministry. And there's many people that come to know Jesus. We have offices in Nigeria and Togo, have four churches in Nigeria, one in Togo. And we want you to know that you become a part of each and everything that this ministry does when you become a partner. You can see the information right there on your screen so that you're able to become a covenant partner with us. And as you do, we want you to know that we pray over each and every one of your offerings so that God will multiply it back to your hands according to His Word. His Word says in Luke 6:38 that He gives back, pressed down, shaken together, running over to make room for more. The New Living Translation says, whatever measure you use in giving, large or small, it'll be used to measure what is given back to you. So we want you to know that God loves you, He'll take care of you, and He'll multiply the seed that you sow in this ground with this ministry. Remember that Jesus is Lord, and Jesus loves you, and so do we.